$200 million and 116,000 metric tons consumed annually. That is the value of the sea urchin market.
Renowned worldwide for their usage in sushi as uni, these pieces of seafood have a little known secret.
Each and every time you place one of these glowing golden strips in your mouth, you're consuming the eggs or sperm of a sea urchin.
Tasty, right?
But what exactly is a sea urchin? In simple terms, they are spiny echinoderms, which is the same family as sea stars or sea cucumbers. Urchins thrive in an intertidal zone, which is the area between high and low tide. In the vicinity of the shorelines, the urchins graze on algae and kelp growing on the seabeds. With this diet, sea urchins may consume anywhere from 1 to 4% of their body weight in marine vegetation daily.
In an average human, this would equate to eating up to 7 pounds of food every day, nearly twice the amount of our normal diet. And this diet provides the necessary needs for the urchins to produce uni.
However, the process of harvesting sea urchins is difficult.
Through generations, urchins have been harvested by diving and farming. Diving, which has been the most common and traditional method, involves simply swimming down to the urchin zones and picking them up in nets.
However, this process is unreliable as only around 50% of the urchins collected have marketable uni.
Farming, on the other hand, encompasses raising the organism from an egg until it reaches adulthood, which takes around 6 months. This process is very space and energy intensive compared to the amount of harvestable urchins.
But Californian and marine biologists have discovered a better and more sustainable way to farm urchins. This process is called urchin ranching. As opposed to diving or farming, ranching urchins has both less cultivation time and better yield rates for uni, with close to 95% of ranch urchins containing uni. The first step of this process involves divers collecting large quantities of urchins from barrens, where urchins have exhausted all possible food options.
These starving creatures can survive for years without food, but they can't be consumed because they don't contain uni.
These empty shells are brought back to the surface in mesh bags and transported to ranches where the urchins are fed for 10 to 12 weeks.
During that time period, the urchins are fed with kelp. Once the gonads are fully formed, the urchins are then sold to the customers and distributors, including high-end restaurants.
Other than consumption, sea urchins may also be used for other products. Various other applications include dye, jewelry, and decoration.
They also contain high levels of zinc and calcium, which may be used in plant fertilizers.
But outside of their commercial uses, marketing sea urchins is also important for another reason.
Here you can see a large population of urchins all clustered in a largely barren area.
The urchins crept across the ocean floor, consuming and devastating kelp with their ravenous hunger.
Close to 90% of all California kelp forests have been wiped out, and the organisms once present starved. This is the problem with sea urchins, an extra motivation for harvesting them.
Whether with diving, farming, or ranching, each step in growing the urchin industry
is a valuable contribution to reducing the impact of sea urchins on the environment.
So the next time you eat a piece of uni, remember that you are helping the environment in your own small way.
And savor that sweet,
salty taste of sea urchin gonads.